Google showed off Android Auto in 2014 as a safe and convenient way to use your phone in the car. There was a lot of hype surrounding the feature when it first launched, but not so much during the past 4 years. My car does have Android Auto integration, and I actually use it on a daily basis. So here's a video showing you what's changed and what it's like to use Android Auto in 2019. But before that, this video is sponsored by Wondershare. Like anyone on this planet, you've definitely deleted some files that you didn't mean to lose. Recover It is Wondershare's data recovery software that can easily and quickly get your files back from the trench far beyond the recycle bin. Check out the link in the description box below to go try Recover It now. One of the best parts about Android Auto is that it's very accessible. Your car doesn't even need Android Auto integration, Bluetooth, or USB port. Android Auto is a free Android app, so all you need to do is launch it on your phone and keep the display easily visible with something like a car mount. But yeah, your phone screen is a bit too small to keep a good eye on when you're driving, so the best experience is still going to be with the car with a big touchscreen display and native Android Auto integration. In this optimal configuration, you need a good micro USB or USB-C cable to connect your Android phone. Your phone needs to be running Android 5.0 Lollipop or above with, of course, a data plan. It's obviously a very easy and simple setup, but nitpicking here, cable management can be a bit annoying since I still don't know where to put my phone along with this long cable. Maybe I'll just get a shorter cable later on, but this is something I've always wondered about in every Android Auto car that I've been in. The great thing is that you don't have to worry about battery life because your phone is constantly charging, but hopefully Google can come up with a native wireless option in the future. Android Auto's UI is something that's seen little to no change since 2015. Google has done some very minor UI adjustments over the years, but the philosophy has always been, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. There's five main menu buttons: Maps and Navigation, Calls and Contacts, Home Screen, Music and Audio, and Exit Android Auto. The notifications pop up at the top here with a minimal amount of info so you don't get distracted by reading it. It's a very simple UI that's really easy to use, and it's definitely a much more aesthetically pleasing experience than the native software from any of the car manufacturers. However, this UI was clearly meant to be used with a touchscreen. My 2018 Mazda 6 does have a touchscreen, but it only works with the native Mazda software and Apple CarPlay, and strangely, not with Android Auto. I don't know why Mazda went with this configuration, but I hope I can fix it later on with the software update. While I've gotten used to using the physical knob for this UI, it's a total step down from the all touchscreen experience that I used to have on another car. Physical controls are slow to navigate, feels clunky, and just feels like I'm not getting most of the advantage that Android Auto was truly made for. Yeah, I know I shouldn't even use my car display while driving, but there are those times when you suddenly have to navigate to another address, or you're stuck in traffic and you really need to change to another song. Well, this is where Google Assistant comes in. Either by pressing a dedicated physical button or saying OK Google, you can activate Google Assistant to control almost any element of the Android Auto experience. In practice, I'd say it's mostly a success, like a solid B. My biggest issue with it is that on every Android Auto car that I've tried, it's kind of hard to get Google Assistant's attention. I'm mostly yelling, "OK Google," as speaking normally or in certain tones don't get picked up in the car. Otherwise, voice commands work pretty well. You do have to be really specific, like saying play a certain podcast without saying the name of the app will play it on Google Podcasts instead of my Spotify app. But once you get a hang of how the voice commands work, it performs as you would expect, and you can listen to your latest texts and reply back, get directions to a new destination, or play a specific playlist from your music library. These functions aren't limited to just native Google apps and Spotify either. There are quite a few third-party apps that are compatible with Android Auto. Obviously, you can't use Netflix or YouTube to watch videos on here, but some popular messaging and music apps are compatible with Android Auto. Much like the development side of Wear OS, the level of quality and functionality on third-party apps vary. Some messaging apps support reading assistance and fully-fledged replies, while others only support notifications and nothing else. Some music apps support all the features of the mobile app, while others only support a few. So you sort of don't know what you're going to get with each app until you actually try them. But honestly, these are all nitpicks. You can quickly make calls, use your music podcast app, and navigate with Google Maps or Waze. That's basically all you need to do while driving. What matters is how easy it is to do these simple things, and Android Auto is very good at that, depending on if you have a functioning touchscreen. After revisiting Android Auto in 2019, I've realized that it hasn't seen much change over the years. That hasn't been a bad thing, as it's easy to use, got everything you need while driving, and still looks better than your car's native software. But there's definitely some much needed improvement on some things like UI design for non-touch displays and voice recognition with Google Assistant. Other than that, there's a ton of future potential here with more car manufacturers putting Android Auto into their cars and new cars with 5G connectivity so you don't even need a phone to run Android Auto. Or there's a more likely future of Google doing all of this with Android Automotive. Android Automotive is Google's ongoing project to actually put Android on cars. It looks like it has some of the same design elements as Android Auto, but it's going to be able to do a lot more. Android Auto is basically just a projected infotainment system from your phone, while Android Automotive is getting Android to run your car. Google's already made a bunch of partnerships with car manufacturers to get this rolling, so let's see where this goes. Alright, that's going to do it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Like this video if you did, and subscribe to my channel for more obscure tech content like this. Also, let me know if you have Android Auto on your car and if you use it or not. Make sure to go check out Recover It in the description box below, and I'll see you guys on the next one.